Jones family, and they always keep their house and yard looking in tip-top shape. This is their neighbor Fred, and it always seems like he's, you know, trying to keep up with the Joneses. But what Fred doesn't know is that the Joneses use Yardworks for all their top-quality mulch and topsoil needs. They deliver it when you want it, and you don't have to deal with the mess of all those plastic bags. So don't feel like you need to keep up with the Joneses. Be the Joneses and give Yardworks a call to get mulch and topsoil delivered to your home.
You still chase cars all day.
Just the damaged ones.
What would you do if you caught one?
Tell them to call 250-5050.
Smart dog.
Call the heavy hitters at Pendleton Lawson.
Spring is finally here, and you're just itching to upgrade your stuff. The best way to do that is in a new Hyundai. Like the Santa Fe with an available class exclusive digital smartphone key and loads of the latest technology. Drive your upgrade to deliver. Although we can do that too during the Hyundai Spring Upgrade Event.
Get 0% APR for 60 months, plus zero payments for 90 days. Or sign and drive today. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
NBC 12, on your side in RVA.
Check this, March is back, so let's make up for lost time with more action on FanDuel Sportsbook, including making someone like you a millionaire. Get a free shot at the $1 million payout every day you bet the tournament.
Today marks 40 years since President Ronald Reagan was nearly assassinated. He'd only been in office about 70 days when he was shot by John Hinckley. Reagan came very close to losing his life. Pat Collins looks back.
It was a day that the world stood still. Ronald Reagan, the 40th president of the United States, shot and wounded as he was leaving the Washington Hilton Hotel downtown. Reagan's Secret Service codename, Rawhide. This is the way it played out on the police radio. At the hospital, Reagan told his wife, Nancy, "Sorry, honey, I forgot to duck." Reagan spent about 11 days in that hospital before being released. Now, 40 years later, the Secret Service displays a replica of the gun used and bulletproof glass from that limo. The glass, the round hit before it ricocheted into the president's chest, breaking a rib and puncturing a lung. Del Quinton Wilbur knows all the details. He wrote the book, Rawhide Down.
The people don't understand how dramatic the day really was. They don't understand that the president's life hung in the balance of an inch, a split-second decision, and a split-second itself. The president's life, if not for the heroic actions of the Secret Service agent that we've seen, and the doctors and the nurses at GW Hospital, he would have died.
Charged in the case would be assassin John Hinckley, a college dropout, failed songwriter with a pretend girlfriend. Hinckley, they say, wanted to kill the president and gain fame to impress actress Jodie Foster. They say he was obsessed with Foster and watched her movie Taxi Driver 15 times. Hinckley found not guilty by reason of insanity and spent a number of years in treatment at St. Elizabeth's. He was released in 2016. Back at that Hilton Hotel, a plaque commemorating what happened there that March 30th day, 1981, the day Ronald Reagan was shot. I'm Pat Collins, NBC News, Washington.
You may remember White House Press Secretary James Brady, Secret Service Agent Tim McCarthy, and Police Officer Thomas Delahunty were all wounded. All survived, but Brady suffered brain damage and was permanently disabled.
An Asian woman in New York City is in the hospital after being attacked while walking to church. We do want to warn you, the video you are about to see is hard to watch. Surveillance video shows a man kick a 65-year-old woman to the ground, stomping on her several times. Police say he made anti-Asian statements, including, quote, "You don't belong here." The attacker then walked away. A building security guard watched the attack unfold. He did nothing, and it gets worse. New York's Asian Hate Crimes Task Force said, quote, "The cold-hearted building security guard not only He has since been suspended, and so too have others who worked in that building who saw what was happening and stood by in his name. Well, this afternoon, we are getting a better idea of what spending a year in space could do to our bodies. Astronaut Scott Kelly's heart shrank after spending nearly a year in space. Kelly was aboard the International Space Station in 2015 and 2016. A new study says the largest chamber of his heart shrank in mass by more than 25% by the time he returned to Earth. The study's authors say that's because the lack of gravity meant the heart didn't have to pump as hard. But a smaller heart doesn't seem to have an adverse effect on Kelly.
Accurate, reliable, breaking weather specialists. This is NBC 12 First Alert Weather.
It is a beautiful day here on Earth with blue skies, temperatures climbing to the lower 70s. A really nice look at our JES Skycam this afternoon as the temperatures again making it to the lower 70s. We're up to 71 degrees at our JES Wilderness site in Mineral in Louisa County, 71 in Richmond at St. Christopher School, and 68 degrees in Hopewell. Our high temperature is making it into the low to mid 70s today. This is about as nice as it gets around here. Low humidity, a gorgeous day to be outdoors. Tonight, we'll notice those clouds starting to increase as we head into your Wednesday morning. Temperatures in the mid-50s when you wake up and step out the door tomorrow morning. And as we look at tomorrow's forecast, it is a first alert weather day now for that possibility of some strong or severe storms, especially late in the afternoon and into the evening hours. Temperatures climbing into the mid and upper 60s during the afternoon. I think the morning hours are probably going to be fine, just cloudy, mainly dry though through noontime. Better chances for showers and downpours late in the day, and that's the next big thing we're tracking. This marginal risk for a strong, severe storm, so level 1 out of 5 for the Storm Prediction Center on a 1 to 5 scale, 5 is the worst. So tomorrow is a pretty low chance. We're just going to keep an eye on the possibility for some gusty winds, downpours, and a very small chance for a brief tornado during the late afternoon into the evening hours. Here's the hour-by-hour forecast. We're at 8 o'clock in the morning when you wake up and get out the door on Wednesday. Cloudy skies, a little bit of drizzle, west of the Richmond area. As we get toward 2 or 3 in the afternoon, though, here comes those showers and downpours, and we'll see a couple rounds of rain likely during the afternoon, and then again late in the evening, right around midnight, we could have some more showers, maybe a couple of thunderstorms moving through. And I think the highest chance of seeing a strong or severe storm, once again, will be across Southside Virginia, very similar to the last couple of potential severe weather events we had to watch the last few weeks. Our hour forecast for Thursday morning, some showers and downpours around. That starts to exit the picture as we head into the midday hours of Thursday, but then it's going to turn a lot colder around here by the end of the week. Total rainfall amount is going to be pretty impressive as we head through Wednesday night and early Thursday morning. More than an inch from many spots, potentially pushing toward an inch and a half of rain in a couple of locations across central Virginia. Something we'll be keeping a close eye on is that possibility for some minor poor drainage flooding, street flooding as we head into Wednesday evening, and that may cause some slowdown for the evening drive tomorrow night. The marginal risk for flash flooding across the area, that's a pretty low chance as well. But again, we'll be watching this closely. Keep that NBC 12 First Alert Weather app handy on Wednesday. We'll send out any updates or any alerts we get tomorrow. Temperatures again getting much colder by Thursday and Friday, upper 40s to near 50 for high temperatures. And look at those lows in the upper 20s by Friday night and Saturday morning. It's going to be a little bit chilly to close out the work week and start off the weekend. So Saturday and Sunday look much nicer. Lower 60s Saturday, lower 70s for Easter Sunday. Picture perfect around here to close out the weekend. And those 70s hold on for Monday and Tuesday. Kirk?
Okay, Nick, thank you. The Voice getting a new coach. Ariana Grande is joining the hit NBC show. That story is still ahead at 4:30.
But first of four, many of you are likely racing to get your taxes done, but you should really be taking your finances and taxes into consideration all year long. We've got tips you need to know coming up next in Your Money.
First Alert Weather is sponsored by Mechanicsville Honda and Mechanicsville Toyota. Sales department open 7 days a week.
It's Portage, Sorrento, and Telluride. Part of the Kia's tough and ready lineup, all-wheel drive SUVs. Right now, lease a 2021 Sportage LX for $169 a month.
You said no. I know you meant yes.
Serving Virginia for almost 3 decades. Right now, we're offering you
no interest, no monthly payments, and no down payment until 2022. Windows, roof, siding, and trim, and gutters. We'll also be giving you 60% off labor just to make improving your home a little bit easier. Give us a call or go online to make your appointment today. And thank you from all of us at Paramount Builders.
I was in foot pain for 20 years. I bought all these products. Not a single one worked. When I drove past the Good Feet store, I thought, I'm going to stop in. What could it hurt? They wanted to make sure that they gave me the right arch support for my feet, not somebody else's feet. And you just knew, like, Good Feet, just when they got on the right ones, they were like, oh. I'm Teresa, and that's my Good Feet story.
See for yourself. A free personalized arch support fitting at the Good Feet store.
If your dry eye symptoms keep coming back, inflammation in your eye might be to blame.
Looks like a great day for achy, burning eyes.
Over-the-counter eye drops typically work by lubricating your eyes, and they provide temporary relief.
Ha! These drops probably won't touch me.
Xiidra works differently, targeting inflammation that can cause dry eye disease.
What is that? Xiidra? No!
It can provide lasting relief.
Oh.
Xiidra is the only FDA-approved treatment specifically for the signs and symptoms of dry eye disease. One drop in each eye, twice a day. Don't use if you're allergic to Xiidra. Common side effects include eye irritation, discomfort, or blurred vision when applied to the eye, and unusual taste sensation. Don't touch container tip to your eye or any surface. After using Xiidra, wait 15 minutes before reinserting contacts.
Got any room in your eye?
Talk to an eye doctor about twice a day Xiidra.
I'd prefer you didn't.
Xiidra, not today, dry eye.
It's Portage, Sorrento, and Telluride, part of the Kia Stuff and Ready lineup. All-wheel drive SUV.
Right now, lease a 2021 Sportage LX for $169 a month.
Call the Joel Weaver Firm, 800-8000. Take a look at this fiery explosion at a company gas station, which is now under investigation. Security video shows a man walking the side of a car parked in the hub. Suddenly, there's a bright flash and a passenger falls out of the vehicle. Two men run off as that fire begins to grow. It doesn't take long before it envelops the pumps. Police are now looking for the fare. The clerk said he saw the men pour gas on the car before it burst into flames. Keep in mind, there's a difference between preparing your taxes and tax planning.
And that difference can mean a lot of money. Kelly Avellino explains that today is your money. Everyone should be doing their taxes or preparing their taxes by the spring deadline. But it's not just getting the forms filled out. NBC 12's financial expert Carl Carlson is breaking down the tax strategies that we should really be putting into action all year round to save and to grow money. There's a difference between doing your taxes and tax planning or financial planning. Everybody ultimately is going to do their taxes, but how you grow your investment and plan for retirement is something that you should really be doing the entire year, not just in April or May.
That's more tax preparation. They're just preparing your taxes, so don't think much of it as tax planning. And here's just a quick example. If someone were age 65, a couple, they retired, now they're going to start taking money out. And let's say their Social Security is $50,000 a year, but they want $125,000. So they also take out $10,000 out of an IRA, maybe $15,000 out of savings, maybe $20,000 out of Roth IRA, and then sell $30,000 worth of stocks with a $10,000 capital gain. Right there, they got $125,000 all tax-free. So that's what it comes down to when you think about tax planning.
We have a little bit of extra time to get our taxes done. What's your best advice for those who are trying to get that chore completed?
We have until May 17th now. That's the new deadline. And here's the way I would kind of look at it. Rather than just always, you know, should I put money in an IRA or not, and do I have money available out of my cash flow, think about the overall tax planning strategies. Like, there's really seven key things. When you're ready to start taking money out of investments, that's when all this tax planning you're doing now will come into effect. So those seven key things are going to be Social Security claiming strategies. Those depend on what you're doing now for IRAs and Roth IRAs. And then number two, Roth conversion strategies. So that's things like how and when do I convert my IRA to a Roth IRA. And then number three, withdrawal strategies, which types of accounts do I take money out of and when. This is all tax planning. And then number four, coordinating your itemized deductions with your withdrawal strategy. So that would be, if you have a whole lot of medical expenses in 1 year, so you have a big itemization. But then you can also maybe bunch 2 or 3 years worth of your charitable contributions all in that same year too. And then that might be the year you take the money out of your IRA, so you don't have to pay as much tax on it. And then number five is the, do I put the money in the traditional IRA, the Roth IRA? What types of accounts do I need, and what types of accounts should I have? Number six, then, is what types of investments should I own in each type of account? And that's going to be very different. And then finally, number seven, how do I coordinate all my insurance products with my tax planning? So you can see there's a lot there that comes into account rather than just do I put money in an IRA or not.
And that's your money. I'm Kelly Avellino for NBC12.
We continue to follow some breaking news out of Richmond. This car has been submerged in Swan Lake in the city's Bird Park. We told you about this at the top of the hour. The good news is that nobody was found inside.
And right now, as you can see on your screen, you are taking a look at a live picture as crews work to tow the car out of the water. Our photojournalist on the scene tells us the car is attached to a tow truck, and as you can see, people are helping with the rope. There is no word on how this car got into the water, but again, divers checked it out and learned no one was inside.
We'll continue to follow this story and bring you updates as needed. First in Four continues right after the break.
Hi, Will Nichols, Crossroads Corp. You know, buying a new car can be difficult and time-consuming, but at Crossroads, we go the extra mile to make it easy and to simplify the process with options that are uniquely ours. We're part of one of the largest automotive groups on the East Coast with access to 13 Ford locations. We offer state-of-the-art digital signing with online options, remote delivery, and most importantly, a friendly staff that will value your time. Everyone's situation is different, but no matter what it is, let me help you to your next move forward. And as always, don't worry about what you can't do, just tell me what you can do.
Are you looking for a locally owned residential or commercial company that provides turf care, mowing, landscaping, and irrigation services? Call 798-0492 and schedule your consultation today. Thank you for choosing RJ Davis Lawn Care, and let us kill your weeds.
It's been a long decade these past 2 years, but Mark still has a lot left in the tank, which means more basketball. And what I'm talking about, more favorites moving on, 2-3 zones, and camera time for the bench heroes. And the best part, more action for everyone on FanDuel Sportsbook.
Let's go.
It means plenty more opportunities to be the next fan that we thank 8 million. We've already made one FanDuel winner. Bet the tournament every day for more chances to be next. Game's on. FanDuel Sportsbook.
When it comes to protecting your home's interior, you cannot afford to wait any longer to get a new roof from Hanover Roofing. Hanover Roofing is a Class A contractor with the skill and experience to meet any roofing need. Give us a call at 550-7700 or visit us at hanoverroofing.com.
Apple Nay Bonet finally tried the new Popeye's fish sandwich, and it's beautiful.
Love that fish from Popeye's. It's so similar to the chicken sandwich. This is handcrafted full plate like myself.
Try the Cajun flounder sandwich today.
Richmond Gas Works wants you to know that natural gas is as safe as it is reliable, but it's important to use caution with any energy source. Smell, look, and listen to the signs of a gas leak. If you smell something like rotten eggs, see plants that appear to be dying, or hear roaring like a train or even a faint whistle, act fast, even when the signs are small. Don't do anything that could cause a spark, like using your phone or powering off fixtures like lamps or appliances. Leave the building or area immediately. Then, call 911. Richmond Gas Works, the smart choice.
Right now at 4:30, emotional testimony continues in the trial of a former Minneapolis police officer. Today, onlookers took the stand, including a then 17-year-old girl who recorded the viral Facebook video showing Derek Chauvin kneeling on George Floyd's neck for 9 minutes and 29 seconds. The state's witness cried as she told the court how she finds herself apologizing to Floyd for not intervening and saving his life. The trial is expected to last at least 3 weeks.
And tributes continue to pour in for 13-year-old Lucia Bremer. The Richmond Strikers say she was a member of their club, and the team has created a memorial for the team off Ponce Track Road in Henrico. Ahead on Live at 5, Karina Bolster will share how you can leave condolences for her friends and family.
And we are staying on top of some breaking news this afternoon. Take a look at this live picture from Swan Lake at Bird Park in Richmond. You can see a car that was submerged in the water is now being pulled out of the lake. We are not sure how it ended up there in the first place, but we will continue to bring you updates and developments as they're made. There's no one inside the car. That is important to note. Nobody has been located inside of this vehicle. First of all, Pfizer and BioNTech say they are now hoping to manufacture 2.5 billion doses of their vaccine by the end of this year. The company will also start a phase 3 trial in the U.S. on a freeze-dried version of its vaccine next month. The CDC reports that full vaccination, the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines, were both 90% effective at preventing infections. As of Monday, more than 95 million people have received at least one vaccine dose. More than 52.5 million people are fully vaccinated. President Biden is preparing to unveil a wide-ranging plan to improve the nation's infrastructure and rebuild the economy. At the same time today, focusing on equity and inclusion from new efforts to support the Asian American community to his first slate of judicial nominees. Alice Barr has the latest from Washington, now at 4:30.
President Biden today signing an extension of the Paycheck Protection Program, giving small businesses until the end of May to apply for the forgivable loans.
Without me signing this bill today, there are hundreds of thousands of people who lose their jobs and small family businesses that might close forever.
The White House focused on reviving the economy as President Biden prepares to roll out a massive infrastructure plan that's already facing Republican pushback over its multi-trillion dollar price tag.
And they want to do another massive spending bill, which will include additional debt.
The administration signaling the president may propose higher taxes for corporations or the wealthy to pay for his plans.
He believes that there's more that can be done to make the corporate tax code fair to reward work, not wealth.
Earlier today, President Biden pledging to invest in Latino-owned businesses during remarks to the Hispanic Chamber of Commerce.
Together, we're going to get our economy back on track and hang an open sign on tens of thousands of Latino-owned small businesses.
The president also promising more support for the Asian American Pacific Islander community, including a new task force aimed at ending xenophobia amid a troubling increase in anti-Asian violence and discrimination.
DOJ is taking steps to strengthen hate crimes data reporting.
Meanwhile, President Biden unveiling a diverse group of 11 judicial nominees, the first glimpse of his plans to reshape the federal courts after 4 years of Republican control. In Washington, Alice Barr, NBC News.
Let's take a moment and check out SkyCam this afternoon. Beautiful day, warm temperatures, not a cloud in the sky. Things changing. Tomorrow, though, we have a chance for severe weather, and that's why Wednesday, a first alert weather day. Standing by is weather specialist Nick Russo to explain. Nick.
Hey, Kurt. Yeah, we have a beautiful evening outside tonight. Warm temperatures soaring into the lower 70s. That is warmer than average. We got into the late part of March talking about temperatures that are, again, pretty warm outside this evening. 71 degrees in Hanover, 70 in Tappahannock, 71 in Petersburg. Bring the lower 70s down toward Emporia as well. Get outside, soak up that sunshine, and enjoy the nice weather while we have it, because things are going to take a turn tomorrow as we're talking about a first alert weather day now for the threat of some strong, eventually severe thunderstorms late tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow evening. Even if we don't get the severe storms, we're still talking about heavy rainfall tomorrow night as we head into the afternoon and evening hours. And they get two rounds of rain, one during the mid to late afternoon, and then another late tomorrow evening toward midnight. It's a marginal risk. That's a low threat for severe storms. Level 1 out of 5 from the Storm Prediction Center. Gusty winds, minor flooding, the primary concern. Can't completely rule out a weak tornado, but that's a pretty small chance for tomorrow. 3 p.m. to 1 a.m. on late Wednesday evening to early Thursday morning is going to be the time to watch. It is a little bit of a broad time frame because of the fact that we have potentially two rounds moving in, again, mid to late afternoon, and then again late in the evening toward midnight. Then we're watching the possibility for a breeze coming out Friday morning, and then again Saturday morning as temperatures turn much colder later on this week. Coming up for your first alert forecast, we'll take a look at the time today, what to expect with Easter weekend. That's on the way. Kurt?
Okay, Nick, thank you. A 12-year-old Colorado boy in critical condition after reportedly taking part in a dangerous social media challenge. Joshua Haliosis was found unconscious in the bathroom. His family thinks he was trying to choke himself with a shoelace. They believe it was part of what's called the blackout challenge, which encourages children to choke themselves until they lose consciousness. Doctors say Joshua is now brain dead.
They're begging him on the floor, pleading to see if they can give me some time. Just don't give up on him, don't give up on him. I'm paying the price right now. I'm living the life, and I hate other parents to go through this.
The family hopes their story encourages other parents to discuss these type of harmful challenges on social media with their kids so no one gets hurt.
A ninth woman has come forward accusing New York Governor Andrew Cuomo of inappropriate behavior. This latest allegation comes with photographs. 55-year-old Sherry Bill claims these pictures show how Cuomo, quote, manhandled her while touring her flooded home in 2017 when upstate New York was hit hard by flooding. Bill says the governor kissed her on both of her cheeks without her consent.
Just tell by the way he was approaching me that, you know, the way he grabbed my face, and it was very inappropriate to me.
The governor's legal team is firing back at Bill's claim by releasing their own pictures from that day, saying, quote, during these times of crisis, the governor has frequently sought to comfort New Yorkers with hugs and kisses. Bill is the third woman to say the 63-year-old gave or attempted to give an unwanted kiss. Cuomo has previously apologized and said he's never been inappropriate with anyone.
This, where a massive fire has partially destroyed a condominium. More than 100 firefighters were dispatched to Baytown Towers Monday afternoon. Fire crews say nearly 35% of the building was damaged, and all 12 units destroyed, and the entire fourth floor collapsed. Thankfully, everybody made it out in time. The cause of this fire is still under investigation.
Many are still reeling in the wake of a deadly D.C. carjacking that left a food delivery driver dead.
And now investigators are revealing they are seeing an uptick in some of the crimes by some law enforcement believe they're seeing this big jump.
And busted while cooking. However, police say it wasn't his face that got him caught. We'll share how they were able to identify a drug suspect on the run for 5 years.
And if you're following the stock market, here are the closing numbers. A down day across the board. First and fourth continues in just a moment.
Listen up. This is going on way too long. If we're going to win this game, we've got to go big.
Zaxby's new signature sandwich with Zax sauce for new spicy Zax sauce. Only at Zaxby's.
If you need new floors, I highly recommend 50 Floor. We use them for our carpet and laminate. The process was a breeze. After we picked our products, the installers handled everything. They were fantastic, and I didn't have to lift a finger.
If you need new floors and don't want to lift a finger, then call 50 Floor and take advantage of their free installation sale. Plus, save an extra $100 with promo code MAKO. Pay no interest and paid in full in 12 months.
Call 877-54-54-54.
People are always finding ways to save money.
I learned to cut hair.
Unfortunately, Xfinity makes saving easy and less awkward. Because when you have Xfinity Internet and add mobile, you can save up to $300 a year on wireless. Two great products, one great value. Saving made easy. Can your internet do that? This place can fix it. Thanks.
Get started with Xfinity Internet for $39.99 a month for 12 months. Plus, add Xfinity Mobile and you could save up to $300 a year. Switch today. Thank you.